one of the great scholars in Islam on comparative religion, Sheikh Ahmed Deedat. Brother Ahmed Deedat is well known for his effort in the world of tabligh, whether east, west, north or south. So for his presence tonight here, we say Alhamdulillah. Please join me in welcoming him to this mosque, Masjid Noor, South Sea, Nairobi. To you, Brother Ahmed Deedat, the Muslim community in South Sea and Nairobi as a whole and the nearby districts have gathered tonight for your first occasion for a week-long trip in the Republic of Kenya. I am sure many among you have seen or heard cassettes by Brother Ahmed Deedat or have read books by Brother Ahmed Deedat and his tabligh group. So tonight we are blessed for him to be here. Therefore, my role was just to say that, and I will now call upon our Sheikh, Sheikh Abdullah Zubaydi, to welcome Brother Sheikh Ahmed Deedat to this occasion. Sheikh Abdullah.
Machache aliyosema Bwana Ahmed Warfa, Muhammad Warfa, mmeelewa maana maneno aliyosema. Na mimi sina mengi ya kusema ila kuamba huu siku wa leo ni neema kubwa sana kwetu sisi watu wa Nairobi na hasa watu wa South Sea. Tusema kwamba neema hii ya Sheikh Ahmed Deedat kuja hapa ni rizqun saqahu Allah ilayka. Maana Mwenyezi Mungu ametuletea neema hii. Na ni wajibu wetu kuipokea kwa mikono miwili na kumshukuru Mwenyezi Mungu, sababu Mwenyezi Mungu akikupa neema ni wajibu wako kushukuru. Na ukishukuru basi Mwenyezi Mungu hukuzidia, hukuzidishia. Yaani kama mfahamu vyo wengine kama sisi twafahamu kwamba Sheikh Ahmed Deedat alikuja hapa kwa muda mrefu uliopita. Lakini twataraji safari yake hii Mwenyezi Mungu amjalie, twamuombea Mungu Rabbi hifadhhu fiha na umruhu yatul. Mwenyezi Mungu amjalie amhifadhi na ampe umri mkubwa awe akija miraran wa tikrara. Kwa haya machache sina la kusema zaidi ila kumkaribisha Sheikh Ahmed Deedat aanze muhadhara wake. Tafadhali Sheikh Ahmed.
Yeah, I think so. This is no, I'll stand. No, I think this thing must be carrying something. I don't know. Is this necessary?
It is.
It's necessary.
Is it to some commitment? No.
في شان حبيبه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولن ترضى عنك اليهود ولا النصارى حتى تتبع ملتهم. Sadaq Allah, Sadaq Allah al-Azim. Respected Imam and my dear brothers and sisters, I read to you a very short verse, an ayah from the Holy Quran, from Surah Al-Baqarah. Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 120. In it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reminds us all Muslims about our relationship, the relationship between ourselves and the Jews and the Christians. He says, Allah says, وَلَنْ تَرْضَى أَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَنْ نَصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِيَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. Be on guard, be warned, O Muslims, that the Jews and the Christians will never, never be satisfied with you Muslims unless you follow their brand of religion. Lan in Arabic is a double negative. Never, never, most certainly not. They'll never be satisfied with you. We tell them that we believe in Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, revered Moses, may peace be upon him. We tell the Christians that we believe in Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, revered Jesus, may peace be upon him. That we believe in his miraculous birth, that he was born without any male intervention. We believe that he is the Masih, the Messiah, translated Christ. We believe that he gave life to the dead by God's permission, and he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. Does that satisfy them? Does that satisfy the Christians? No. They said, but you see, you don't believe in him as your personal savior. You don't believe that he is your God. Jesus Christ is God Almighty who came down to earth in human form. You don't believe that. That he died for your sins. You don't believe that. So there's a fight. There's a war. Unless you become a Christian. But then the Christians are still not satisfied. The Roman Catholic won't be satisfied unless you become a Roman Catholic. The Anglican won't be satisfied with you unless you become an Anglican. The Jehovah's Witness won't be satisfied with you unless you become a Jehovah's Witness. The Seventh-day Adventist won't be satisfied with you unless you become a Seventh-day Adventist. Shit. Man, they're going to divide this Ummah into 1,000 different pieces. And they won't be satisfied. So Allah tells us that they will never be satisfied with you. What are you going to do? There's only one of two things you can do. Either you follow their brand of religion, or you change him. Either you get changed or you change him. Now my first experience, but before I get into that, I said Surah Al-Baqarah. This ayah I quoted was from Surah Al-Baqarah. Now, whenever somebody, anybody, any speaker comes along and gives you any reference from the Holy Quran, you make it your duty to go home and check up in the Quran at home. Not that you are doubting the speaker,